The Formula One circus has made its way to the southern coast of Portugal this week, and it's preparing for what I expect to be a terrific race here in Portimão. ...2.9 miles of track at Portimão, featuring 15 turns, 9 to the right and 6 to the left. There's a lot going on here, a lot of elevation changes that will affect the driver's braking and acceleration. Keep an eye out for the DRS zone on the final straight. That will be the setup for a lot of today's overtaking chances. And as always, a man with plenty of racing experience joins me in the commentary box. Today it's Anthony Davidson. Tell me, Ant, you're no stranger to surviving the melee of turn one. So how do you keep out of trouble when there's so much going on around you?
There are three main things to worry about there, Crofty. Positioning, awareness, and discipline. First, you have to put your car in a bit of space and make sure you have room to react to what the others are doing. Then you have to watch your mirrors and listen to the sounds around you to get a sense of where everyone is. And finally, just don't get too greedy. Just because a gap exists doesn't always mean you should go for it.
It's time to take a look at our starting grid for today's race. Iceman lines up on pole position, and it's Valtteri Bottas that completes the front row. As we continue through the rest of the grid today, we have Hamilton, Verstappen, Sergio Perez and Leclerc, Norris, Sainz, Ricciardo and Pierre Gasly, Fernando Alonso, Vettel, Yuki Tsunoda and Ocon, Stroll, Raikkonen, Antonio Giovinazzi and George Russell, Latifi, Mick Schumacher, Tictum and Nikita Mazepin. Which of these talented drivers will come out on top today?
Guys, you've been great all weekend. Thanks, guys.
Fantastic drive. Just fantastic. You deserved that race win.
And that's it then for the Portuguese Grand Prix. And what a sensational victory they've managed to pull off here. Anthony, tell me, what was it that helped them achieve this success?
Well, I honestly feel it was down to the driver and car today. I mean, we can talk driver skill all day, but if you don't have a solid team to back that, you're never going to get anywhere. When you hit that sweet spot of having both an excellent driver and an incredible car, that's when you see results like those we witnessed today.
Welcome then to the podium, our top three drivers. What a great effort from them today in a very difficult race.